The government's announced an inquiry into flood responses and established new ways to help storm-ravaged growers and businesses. But some aren't completely sold on the new plans. Here's our Hawke's Bay reporter, Henry McMullen.
Fruit on the ground and an uncertain future hanging over.
The irrigation, the wire.
There's still so much silt to sort out and what used to be 50 hectares.
And what you see behind us is pretty much the 25 that we haven't been able to save.
Growers like him have been desperate, but now...
This will conclude some questions that everyone has been having for quite some time now.
With the government in town with ways to fund the recovery.
I think this will actually address many of the needs that people have addressed.
First, helping banks with a loan guarantee scheme.
Well, I'm a realist. Remember, loans are good, but they're suffocating too.
There's also finance for badly damaged but still viable producers. But is it enough?
Why wasn't there just cash buyouts? Why isn't the government just buying out all houses in Category 3? We'd bankrupt the government.
This will enable many growers to get on, and so that's all we can hope for.
Because getting on is what they want to do.
Across the region, crops have been so badly damaged, farmers are now left with no other option but to burn them off.
Yeah, no, it's heartbreaking. It really is heartbreaking.
Another burning issue is the initial flood response. Confirmed today, a government inquiry.
I think there's some obvious things that didn't quite go right.
We want action, we want funding to help communities now. Not next month, not in a year.
And growers cautious about their funding today.
Anything's a help. Whether it goes far enough, I probably doubt, but it is what it is.
In a region still picking up the pieces. Henry McMullen, One News.